Hey, don't be embarrassed. We've all been there. You know, you fell out your boat and now you're stranded and you have no idea where to go from there. You're stuck in Spiritfarer. The amount of Googling I did on Spiritfarer is quite frankly astronomical. I don't think I've ever had to look up so many things in a game before. And today I am here to impart my wisdom on how I got unstuck on Spiritfarer so you guys can be free to sail the seas. Now the first thing I want you guys to do is to open up your map and hover over any island. When you hover over an island, it will show you the resources tab and it will show you spirits and shrines, which are the two things I want you guys to pay attention to. If the spirit or the shrine icon is faded out, that means you've got it already so you don't have to worry. But if you don't, you need to try and find out where the spirit is or what the spirit requires. To unlock these spirits, you'll most likely need a certain ability or to fulfill a certain quest line. That is of course where shrines come in. When you grant spirits passage in the game, they'll give you obols, which of course allows you to unlock new abilities. You want to make sure that you check your inventory to see if you already have enough to unlock a new ability at one of the shrines around the world. Now it's important to note that you only get spirit flowers if you grant your spirit passage through the other door, and then you want to head to Albert's shipyard and upgrade your ship so you can travel to new zones. Now one of the things that got me really stuck in this game was that I didn't realize how world events work. If you look at your map again, you'll see the jellyfish event, maybe you'll see the thunderstorm event, but as you unlock new characters, new events will become accessible and visible to you on the map. This is super important because a lot of requests that characters give you to advance their storyline require you to have certain materials that are only unlockable through these world events. So make sure when you do get a new character that you look around those weird purple things and pay attention to the symbol, see if it's something new. Another thing that's easy to miss is exploration. There might be an island that you haven't visited before, and this is super important because when you go to an island, it will expand the map around that island so you can see more areas. By doing this, each area should be fully explored. Now you might find that characters' requests are stacking up upon each other and you just can't seem to complete even one. You're looking through them and you're thinking how. The first thing that you need to do is to make sure your blueprints table is upgraded to the maximum it can be at the moment. If you're not sure how to get enough money for upgrades at the dock, then you can check out my guide on how to make money in Spiritfarer. Now I'll mention it just in case, but you guys have to open up your journals and check out the quests that you have to see how you should proceed with them. But if you've checked out your journal and you've got all the blueprints and you just don't have the materials, or there's a recipe which you can't quite figure out how to make, there's no harm in Googling it. The Wikipedia is usually spoiler free. In some cases there are special spirits. These spirits do not require you to have a special ability to get to them. They want you to complete a certain quest line, or you obtain them in mysterious ways. Now, I won't spoil that, just make sure you're paying attention to the dialogue that the characters are giving you. And I know this one goes without saying, but make sure you talk to your spirits. If you don't talk to them, sometimes their storyline won't progress, and of course that is quite important for the game, but you guys are probably doing that anyway. Also pay attention to which upgrades you have for your ship. That might sound silly, but there may come a time where you can actually explore an area and you didn't know you could because you upgraded your ship without thinking. So yeah guys, to go over these points again, make sure you hover over each individual area you visited and see if there are any shrines or spirits there. Make sure you visited every island because it will expand and show you other areas on the map that you might not have gone to that may contain spirits. Make sure to check out the world events on the map, such as the jellyfish event or the thunderstorm event, or in the case of some characters, the dragon events. Remember that if you're not sure how to proceed with a request, make sure your blueprint system is fully upgraded so that you can make the right thing for the character's request. And if it's a recipe or something more complicated, there's no harm in Googling it. Other people will probably have the same question as you. And for the clumsy like me, make sure you talk to your spirits, know which upgrades you have, and know if you have any spirit flowers or obols that need to be used. And with that, there's no possible way that you should be stuck unless you have somehow glitched out the game. And as a final secret tip from me, after you've escorted three spirits to the Everdor, maybe you should do some fishing or talk to Francis, the traveling merchant. I just got a feeling about it, just a weird feeling that you should do that. Anyway, I would like to propose a toast to Kat for getting me this cute cherry blossom tea set. Thank you so much, Kat. You are the best. I mean, just look at this. Isn't this perfect? Kat is so thoughtful. Thank you so much, Kat. You're the best. I will be sipping probably herbal tea in this. Yes, quite delicious. Oh, and Blossom, sorry that I didn't post this last week. I've been super busy. But I remember my promise to post more often, which is why I'm last minute uploading this and recording it at 8 p.m. Yeah, Blossoms, if you enjoyed this video, then I want you to put on your favorite feel-good song and start dancing right now. It doesn't matter if you don't think you've got the moves. Hey, guess what? Practice makes perfect. No one's watching, just bust out a move. Trust me, you'll feel better. Put on your favorite feel-good tune. Let's go. Let's lift up your day. All right, guys, I'll see you in the next video. I love you. Be the best.